The wandering albatross can spend weeks at sea without ever returning to land. Once airborne, it hardly even flaps its wings. This remarkable feat is known as dynamic soaring. But how is it possible? With precise high-resolution GPS data and custom navigation software, researchers from the Munich University of Technology have finally found the key to flying for free, a revelation that could lead to advances in drone technology. The albatross's secret is the sheer wind field, an area of 10 to 20 meters above the surface of the ocean where the wind speed changes dramatically. The wind speed is successively reduced by friction the closer it gets to the water. Directly above the water, its speed is virtually zero, but it increases as the wind rises. To understand dynamic soaring, researchers examined the bird's energy management. There are four phases to the albatross's flight cycle: a windward climb, a curve from wind to leeward in the upper altitude region, a leeward descent, and a reverse turn close to the sea that flows back into the windward climb. Energy decreases when the bird is close to the water surface, but increases during the windward climb. Albatrosses use the wind lift as a propulsive force, a sort of outboard engine. This propulsive energy is just enough to overcome the wind's drag. The resulting total energy state, the sum of potential and kinetic energy, is neutral. Because the energy is consistently renewed by the wind, the cycle can be repeated almost endlessly. For the albatross, that means a life on the wing, able to soar far from its nest and feed its young. But if humans can reproduce this dynamic flight pattern in unmanned aerial vehicles, drones could fly far longer and far further on significantly less fuel. For IEEE Spectrum, I'm Celia Gorman.